We pop out at your party, I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery, so tuck your chain. I'm a killer, girl, I'm sorry, but I can't change. We ain't aiming for your body, shots hit your brain. We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing.
All right, this is the Wholesome Podcast. I'm Wholesome B, Mitch. We got Trey always in the building. Today we got two guests. We got Stephanie, we got Nica. It's a different type of environment completely. But it's very interesting.
But first, let's take a shot.
Oh, let's do a shot drink. First. Facts. My bad.
I'm slipping. Yeah. Don't slip up.
Head shot.
Drink. So, I remember when I was younger than 25. I remember a lot of girls getting turned out based off the fact of the curiosity. So I want to know, have y'all ever tried to experience some situation with some girls?
No.
Why not?
I'm just not into it.
So has nobody ever approached you? Really came on to you? And you never been like, no, I really feel this vibe.
Nobody has.
A girl never tried you?
No girls ever tried me.
I know hella girls that would try you right now. So do you not go out?
I do go out.
You from the city?
I go out all the time.
And no girls ever say nothing to you?
No.
I feel like that's highly unlikely.
Probably because guys are always on me.
So guys.
They can be both.
So what you're saying is guys, they just on your tails left and right, up, down.
Yes.
And there's no girls that are actually shooting their shots at you.
Okay, from my experience, is that girls will shoot their shot. But it's like whether or not you're interested in girls or not. I'm personally not really. I'm not interested in girls.
Okay.
So
what happens when a girl shoots their shot at you?
You say no.
I'm flattered. I'm flattered. I love it. And I end up like becoming really good friends with them. I would maybe like think about it.
A girl ain't never ate you up.
No.
So you'll think about it. What's stopping you from going further than that just thinking?
I feel like what's stopping me is the fact that I've never been with a girl.
So you're a little bit nervous. So nerves are stopping you.
Maybe.
So you bout it, but it just the nerves.
Ooh, Lord. I'm like all for it. I'm all for the community, LGBTQ, everything like that. But I don't know if like, I don't know. Yeah, nerves are stopping me.
So what are low-key with the shit?
I don't know.
Where do you go out to? So when you go out, you go out to Minneapolis?
I do. Downtown and uptown.
Where do you go out where no girl has ever approached you?
Go downtown to like Sneaky Brothers.
And like no girl has ever said, hey.
No.
They came out like that. No. You're a decent looking female.
No girls came up to me. Like,
really?
Ass. Yes, like actually.
Well, if she's that bad, why is no girl approaching her?
Maybe they think that I'm into males and not females.
Girl, I have no girls that don't care what you into.
I know girls who don't give a fuck.
They don't give a fuck what you into.
Well, shit. I don't know what to say. I have the one deciding whether or not.
Maybe, have you ever, has this ever happened where you don't know somebody's coming on to you, but they might be?
They're conversing with you. They're trying to figure you out.
It's definitely a possibility because I make a lot of friends when I go out.
What about you, Stephanie? Has somebody ever came on to you without you knowing that they're coming on to you? But later on, they're like, no, I actually like you, but you didn't know that they liked you. You thought it was
major conversation. No female, no.
They make it known first quarter.
No, I've never experienced that.
If somebody is too friendly with me, I feel like they're trying to talk to me. If somebody's extra friendly, you might be shooting your shot.
You gotta shut that shit down first quarter.
Fuck you that friendly for?
Yeah, you a nigga.
This is Minnesota. People are nice. What the fuck do you mean?
No.
Minnesota nice.
Dead ass.
Nah, fuck
people
that.
Are actually nice fuck in Minnesota.
That's nigga don't try me on some foul shit like nigga.
Okay, well,
okay, I feel like niggas are different than females.
No, did what sorry. I said. Like, nigga, you following me or bitch you trying to go the other way?
I feel like it's definitely more obvious when it's a nigga coming to a nigga versus a female coming to a female.
It might be
because
true,
it's very,
it.
Like, the paths cross a lot when it comes to being friendly and hitting on you when it comes to a female. So I wouldn't even notice. Because Minnesota nice, we're friendly.
Yeah.
We're friendly. Like I don't even know that. I assume they just want to be friends.
Yeah.
Like when we go, when the females go to the bathrooms, we make hella friends. Like you know, like dead ass. Like I make lifelong friends dead ass in the bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if they're hitting. I don't know if they're hitting on me or if they just want to be friends. It's different for females and men. For me, hitting on someone from my experience was really, really sad because it's our society. But if they were hitting on me...
What does that mean?
Yeah.
I was going to explain it. If they're hitting on me, they'd be a lot more touchy.
Mm-mm. Everybody so ain't touchy.
Like, no, because...
Everybody ain't touchy.
Okay, the thing is that you can't... I feel like Minnesota's different than every other state. Let's talk about Florida.
Okay.
Let's talk about... I'm sorry, it's down south, right?
Yeah.
Right. Okay, let's talk about Florida.
Yeah, let's talk about Florida.
It's different. Minnesota females would be like, oh my gosh, I love your hair. Okay. I love this necklace. What are you gonna say it for? Then you have a whole conversation with them, right? Right. Is that them flirting with you or just them conversing with
Who's
you?
Who's saying that they're shooting their shots in Minnesota? Nobody's
That's what I'm saying, though. How do you know if they're shooting their shots? You guys are not females. You don't know what he's... Who the fuck's going to be like, I love your hair? Nigga, everybody has their hair shaved. Calm the fuck down. Like, no. Like, calm down.
No girl is saying, I love your hair. Yes. Touching your hair.
Okay, tell me. Do they say that?
Yeah, they do say that. Thank you. It's like that. It's like
everywhere in fucking nice Minnesota. In Minneapolis? Dead ass. They'll be like, I love your hair.
That's how my white girls?
Oh, my God.
That's talking about white girls?
That's why are we bringing race into it?
Because that's
why
what matters.
Why are we bringing race?
Because what black girls say, I love your
race. Why are we bringing race?
No, race matters.
Let's cut it, right?
Race doesn't even matter in that situation, to be honest. Well, to be honest, it doesn't even matter in the situation. So let's actually ask a question that actually matters.
The question that matters is does game differentiate based on race? So somebody, I mean,
race and where they from? It is from the suburb. It is from a city. Mm-hmm. They black or white? Like, is the game stronger? Let me know.
I feel like somebody black in hood. City will have a lot more games.
Yeah, city nigga, hood nigga, nigga from the suburb.
Okay.
What are you more attracted to? Down south? You been? You say you been Florida a lot. What is different?
I feel like the hood niggas are just fun for a while, but then after a while you realize like shit gets real. Bills start coming in and you're like, damn, I want somebody
had a bill.
But I feel like I want somebody that can like hold me down and I don't have to worry about them going to jail.
So you can't hold
another
nigga down.
I don't have to worry about them going to jail or like, oh, maybe one day they don't have a job or one day they do have a job.
I thought you with jailbirds anyway.
Wait, hood niggas be trapping.
I mean, and that hood niggas. A lot of hood niggas go to college.
And then if they like go to jail, they expect you to hold them down.
Hold on, Trey. Let them talk.
You know what I mean? Like,
I don't agree.
Okay, what is your viewpoint on it?
I don't stereotype as in hood nigga and suburban nigga or whatever.
Time out, wait.
But
so
it's
you
a
don't
real
know
thing.
I know some hood niggas.
I know some hood niggas.
Honestly, this question is not valid because it depends on the guy. It's different.
So you don't know the difference between hood and suburban niggas?
No.
Because it's still a difference.
We know they're different. We want your perspective on them niggas.
Okay. What? So you guys are classifying people as hood niggas or suburban
niggas? Yes, I am. So there's hood niggas and suburban niggas. Yeah, I'm classifying.
So what is your difference? Why are you classifying?
Hood niggas are niggas that only have their like GED or like high school diploma.
My definition of hood niggas and suburban niggas, hood niggas is a nigga from the hood. Has nothing to do with what y'all talking about. Hood niggas is a hood nigga from the hood. No. He from the hood. He's a hood nigga from the hood. Suburban nigga from the suburb.
I've never met a hood nigga that's gone to college.
You are never been to the hood then. I went to college, highly intelligent. I went to 10 funerals before I was 21. Like type shit. Like everybody I know sell drugs. The percentage that don't is such a small percentage. Like of my friends,
I view him as like a person that just like made it out.
Who?
Of the hood.
You're currently not a hood nigga. You're not trapping. You got 5 baby mothers. You're not selling drugs. You not a hood nigga. You ain't got guns on
you
your back.
Everybody
like,
I know. You are very stereotypical. Every
hood
nigga.
That's a hood nigga.
No, it's not.
You are foolish. You are lost.
Suburban nigga got that lifestyle.
That's not. Yeah. You're like a hood nigga that's trying to be suburban.
Never would I ever try. I'm a hood nigga.
In my opinion.
Yeah, you a hood nigga? Because I don't trap.
Wait though.
That means
no, you guys shut the fuck up.
Man, go ahead.
I'm so tired of it.
You're wearing.
It's ridiculous. Like right now, we all need to be on each other's side right now. We're like, we're dividing each other.
You just said I'm not. No, wait. He just said, I said you're not hood. He said, I know that. And I was like, okay.
I really grew up with niggas really dying.
End of discussion. I just said, you're not. I literally just said to him, you're not hood. He said, I know.
But I really know niggas that was dying on the niggas that would rob everybody in here. Like, these are my friends.
But no,
I'm making friends was niggas that would rob everybody in this bitch. I know niggas that really, like, died and shit.
I know white girls that'll come in this bitch and rob everybody. I know white people, Mexican people, black people.
Where are you from?
I'm from Nicaragua. Them bitches will rob you, but why are black people the only people that rob? I know people that rob for a living. A white, no, but a white girl there, she will rob you.
It's not white bitches.
And she's not hood. She's from Nicaragua, and she just has to do what she got to do to get her next fix. Like. You don't gotta be a certain race. You don't gotta be from a certain place.
It's not. You
don't have to be from nowhere. If you need it, you gonna do it. If you need it, you gonna do it.
If you're from a certain neighborhood, it's called the hood.
But if you need it, you gonna do it. You don't need to be from the hood to steal.
You
don't need to be from the hood to steal.
It's survival of the fittest.
I know white people, Mexican people, any types of people that'll steal.
You talking about stealing. I'm talking about real life robbery.
Oh, like come in like with a mask?
Yes.
Everybody
fuck a mask. Fuck a mask. Give me your shit type shit.
Fuck a mask. I know a white bitch will come in here right now, smile on your face, and steal all your shit. What are you talking about? You don't have to be from the ghetto. You don't have to be from nowhere. If you need it, you're going to get it, period.
So I'll explain the difference between the suburb and the impoverished area. So the difference between the suburbs and an impoverished area is the fact that impoverished areas are impoverished. It means the majority of people don't have the same utilities, the same things that places in suburban areas have.
If you want it, you're going to get it, period. If you want it, you're going to get it, period.
That's cool if you want it.
From the proverbs,
let me explain the
suburbs, whatever verbs. Poverty, everything. If you want it, you're gonna get it.
So you're saying if you want it, I'm talking people that need it. It's a difference.
I know a white girl right now. She need it.
Nah, you don't understand.
She gonna get it.
I know people that's robbing, so they
baby. She need it and she gonna get it. Period.
You talking about you?
Period. And her parents won't pay for it.
You talking about parents?
No, her parents won't pay for it because they know parents? She need it.
I'm talking
about. But she knows she need it, so she gonna go get it. Period.
But hold on, P. I'm talking people that
it is.
Hold on. We're referring to people with parents. I'm talking.
I've seen it.
But listen. I'm talking people without no parents. I'm talking people that you talking people that would have wants. Some people that have needs. I'm talking about they don't rob somebody. They don't eat for the next week.
Right.
They don't eat if they don't rob nobody.
Right.
They don't sell no dope this week.
Right.
They don't eat.
Right. And I know
they
niggas.
They don't eat a meal.
I know niggas. If they don't fuck that bitch, they don't got no place to live. They don't fuck you that bitch. They ain't got nothing
different.
To eat. I know what you're talking about, okay?
You talking about something
I know
different.
What you're talking about.
I'm talking people that can't survive
if
without
certain aspects.
If
you need it, you're going to get it, and you're going to live how you live it. You feel me?
With white,
Asian, black,
and I know
African, anybody.
The race doesn't matter.
How you live.
Race doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
But the area does.
It doesn't matter your area. Because if you're a white girl and you're off cocaine and your parents won't help you, your family won't help you, your family won't help you, nobody will help you, you're going to steal. White girl, her family could have a Range Rover. $500,000 house, everything, but when they need it, they gonna get it. And they gonna steal it, they gonna do whatever they can to get that fixed. So why do they matter? Thank you. That's
I'll tell
facts.
You why. I'll
That's
tell you why
facts.
It matters.
That's facts. It doesn't
I can
matter.
Explain easily
it
why it matters.
Matter. It doesn't
simply
matter.
Matters because of the fact
it
that she had
matter.
The privilege of having these things available to them. I'm talking people that never had this privilege. They woke up, came out the womb with nothing. They came out the womb with nothing. Parents ain't have nothing. Family ain't have nothing. From the dirt, literally.
Right.
Had nothing from day one, had nothing going forward. All they know is I gotta grind to get everything, and they figure out a way to grind to get it. You're talking about somebody that had something.
You know what? You know what? I know motherfuckers that didn't have nothing. You need to learn the finesse system.
That's a difference, though.
You need to learn how to finesse the system.
I'm talking about kids that went to school.
I know niggas niggas that know how to finesse the system.
You talking about something different. You talking about the suburbs. They with the suburbs.
Yeah, you don't need to be from the suburbs to know how to get it how you live.
Yes, you do. It's a difference. No, it's a difference to getting it how you live because you living differently in the suburbs than you do in the hood.
Don't generalize it to one race.
I never mentioned
race. I don't like making it look like blacks.
Yes, thank you.
No, I never made it about race. I don't like it how you're generalizing it towards people.
I'm basing it on area.
I don't like how you're generalizing by area. Just because you're from the hood, that means you steal, or that means you have
to get sent third. You have a struggle.
White people have a struggle too. No, everybody has a type of struggle. You don't know that.
You ever heard of white privilege?
Yes, I've heard of white privilege.
You don't experience that?
Being a black person from the suburbs.
Hold on, wait for them to get
being, being a black person from the suburbs. It's a struggle. Regardless.
So think of being a black person from an area. Struggle. Think of being a black person from an area that's not from the suburbs, where they ain't got shit. Where the school, there's three books in the whole school.
You talking about shit? The whole school? What school is that?
Nigga, every school in Minneapolis. What the fuck are you talking about?
Every school in Minneapolis has three books.
You go to a classroom. Hold on, wait. Who all went to Minneapolis public school? Technically, I was talking about Minneapolis school because you can go to Minneapolis classroom. And you're never gonna ever gonna go to the next classroom. Everybody's gonna have a book or anything.
Just because you got a book don't mean you finna read it.
Nigga, a book is important. You're wrong. A book is fucking important.
A book don't mean you finna read that shit. I've had plenty of books. I've had plenty of books. I don't read it.
Okay.
I don't read it.
Crazy, huh?
Yeah, that shit was nuts. People started tripping. I kind of seen maybe it was a bunch of people in here. We was doing stuff differently a little bit. Shit got wild. People got passionate.
Yeah, passionate conversation.
At the end of the day, the only thing that matters is, you know, black men don't cheat.
At all.
We appreciate Stephanie, Nica, Trey always in the building, hosting podcast.
That was on fleek. Bitch ain't talking about heat. Put it on.